It's been rattling around my head all week. I can't get it out of my head. I've been watching it on YouTube. I've been listening to the lyrics and they've been soaking into my heart. And I got to just say this to you. I love the picture of this song and I love what it's saying. And I encourage you to embrace it. I encourage you not only to sing it out, but I encourage you to live it out. Let's celebrate His glorious day. I'm going to invite you to stand. Let's sing like we mean this is Easter. Amen.
Was buried beneath thy shame. Who could carry that kind of weight?
What's my tomb?
It was my tomb.
Now you're loving the air that I'm breathing.
Amen? Here's what I want to ask you to do is if you heard him call your name today, by that I mean if you've decided to follow Jesus, if you heard him call your name and you are running out of that grave, you're getting out of what's buried you, it's getting you out of that darkness. If you have responded to his call when he called your name, I'm going to ask you to do two things. One, there's these gift bags up here with some materials and some things that will help you get established. There's some good things that are some tools that will help you as you choose to follow Christ. We want to give you some things that will encourage you. Second thing is, in there, there's some information, some next steps, but also there's a church email address. I would like for you to email me, and I'd like you to tell me your story. I won't use it without your permission, but I would love to know your story. And I would love to know how Jesus made a difference, how you heard him call your name, and you came running out of the grave. So I'm asking you those two things. You can do that when we dismiss and everybody is heading out. You can just grab one of these. And also, if you need to talk to a pastor, there will be pastors around with lanyards on. If you want to talk to one, they are more than happy to visit with you, to pray with you, to encourage you, to do whatever we can to help you get established spiritually. I really want to hear from you. That is so critical. Also, Baptism Bash next week. We're going to celebrate with some people who have made a decision to follow Christ. And I want to just tell you, the testimonies are powerful. It doesn't matter how many people we have. It doesn't matter how many baptismal candidates. I'm just going to tell you, the testimonies have already blessed my heart. And I want to just tell you that God's doing a work. I hope you'll be a part of that. Following the benediction, those of you that want to come and get the gift bags can do so, but you can pick up an Easter lily if you'd like to have one. They're for you to take with you if you would like one, and I invite you to do that after we say the benediction. So Peter's one of the guys that's a little bit hopeless, right? We're going to talk about him a little bit in the next few weeks, but impulsive, gung-ho Peter, doesn't get it, right? So good to know we have hope. He writes this to a group of people going through a tough time. It's a letter that's attributed to him. This is going to be our benediction. I'm going to invite you to put your hands out to receive this. This is from 1 Peter chapter 1. Can't think of a better benediction. Listen to this. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that can never perish, spoil, or fade. Let's embrace life. Let's embrace his goodness. Let's receive his grace. God bless you. You are dismissed.
My sin was heavy, the chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter, I was an orphan.